Buy now, pay later plans are so popular right now. And as people are holiday shopping, more and more of them are using these plans to cover their gifts. But is it really a good idea? We check in with our finance expert, Dan Mercado, with the pros and the cons of those buy now, pay later Christmas shopping plans. Good morning to you.
What's up, Maria? How are you?
I'm good. I'm in the middle of Christmas shopping, so this is info I know that I and a lot of people are going to need. What are some of the benefits of these buy now, pay later plans?
Yeah, well, thanks for keeping me on your list, by the way. So you're shopping online, Maria. You go to checkout and you see that little thing pop up. Hey, wouldn't you like to make 4 easy payments, no interest, no fees? Very tempting. That's what buy now, pay later is. You buy something now, you get the item. And if you pay on time, those installments, there are no interest, no fees, right? Sounds pretty good. The problem, of course, is the temptation to spend is there. The temptation to overspend sometimes can be overwhelming for some consumers.
So are there any risks that people should be aware of?
Yeah. First of all, obviously, it can blow your budget. So we want to be careful of that. Next, if you miss one of those payments, Maria, that's when the trouble starts. Fees. Interest rates. And more importantly, perhaps for some consumers, is that it can actually damage your credit if those, if payments go uncollected. It can actually damage your credit. And as you and I know, that can take a long time to fix. So you want to be super careful when you're trying a buy now, pay later. Don't want to make it a buy now, pay later situation.
Absolutely. We're talking about 7, maybe even 10 years to repair credit mistakes. Yeah. So that is something to consider. Do you have any tips for people who are considering using this for this holiday season?
Absolutely. So number one, make sure you have the cash ready to pay, right? So, the money's in your account. It's just a matter of convenience. Fine. Go ahead and use it. Keep it within your budget, of course. Use a credit card where you get some rewards. If you've got decent credit, Maria, let's use that credit card in your purse because that way you get some cash back, you get some rewards, you build your credit, which is also pretty good. At the end of the day, what we don't want to do is, listen, we all want to be generous around Christmas, but we don't want to be overly generous if it means that you and I are going to be paying for it for a long, long time.
And I always hear the people who love you do not want you to go into debt for them. So certainly something to consider. And, the fact that this is becoming a more popular way to shop, does that indicate something about our economy as a whole right now?
That's a great question. Glad you said that. And especially true for younger consumers who may not have credit yet, right? This is very tempting for them. And the economy, let's face it, there's a lot of folks that are still struggling, and this can be a very tempting, a very alluring thing to do. So especially now during these tough times, we need to be extra careful. If something looks too easy, sounds too good to be true, sometimes it often is. So extra caution is advised.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us, Dan. Have a great one.
Thanks, Maria. Say hi to the gang for me.
Oh, I will.